today I have something kind of cool to show you guys. So I pretty much spent the past few hours creating an old subway map, pretty much what New York Rapid Transit looked like in the early 1900s, more specifically 1908. Because I find a lot of the old maps to be quite confusing to read, you know, personally. And I feel like a lot of younger people, they may assume everything started in 1904 with the IRT, but there were lines in New York way before then, like the Manhattan L's, the Brooklyn L's. So I just wanted to show off some of those lines. And if you want to create your own New York subway map, just go to the link above, jpw.nyc/subway. You can create your own custom subway map and have fun. So pretty much this map covers the original IRT subway that opened in 1904 with the trunk lines that go to 145th, Bronx Park East, and Van Cortlandt Park. Now I know they're labeled as the 1, 2, and 3 trains, and it wasn't like that back then, but I just labeled them that way just to make it look familiar, you know? Because back then the 1 was the Broadway Express. It ran from Van Cortlandt Park to 96th Street, then went express to South Ferry or City Hall. The 2 train was the White Plains Express, which ran from 180th Street, Bronx Park, to Atlantic Avenue in Brooklyn. Like, this was before the line got extended to Flatbush and New Lots. And then the 3 train was the Lenox Local, so it went from 145th Street and Lenox to City Hall or South Ferry. And the IRT subway was still, you know, a baby. So yeah, the 3 was local, the 1 and 2 were express. That's the biggest difference. But now moving on to the Manhattan L's, pretty much there were 4 Manhattan L's: 2nd Avenue, 3rd Avenue, 6th Avenue, and 9th Avenue. The 9th Avenue L in 1908 ran from 155th Street to South Ferry. And I know the way I labeled them is confusing and they weren't like this at all. But to make things easy, the 8 train represents the 3rd Avenue L. The T train represents the 2nd Avenue L. The D train represents the 6th Avenue L, and the K represents the 9th Avenue L, just for this map. So here I have all the stops. I looked at Wikipedia to figure out all the locations and intersections to where these stations were, and which trains ran with what. So as you can see, the 2nd and 3rd Avenue L split at Chatham Square and went up. And this is it running alongside the IRT subway. So I chose the D train as the 6th Avenue L, since today the D train is the IND 6th Avenue Express, just to make it easy to identify. And I chose the K as the 9th Avenue since I couldn't find anything else to choose. Yeah. So if I scroll up here, the 2nd and 3rd Avenue L merge again at 129th Street. 129th Street, I believe, was supposed to be the terminal for 2nd Avenue L trains. But in rush hour, the 2nd Avenue elevated trains were extended to the Bronx via the 3rd Avenue L, and then it merged with the present day 2 train, aka the White Plains Road Line, to Freeman Street. This sounds like a history lesson, but I don't mean to lecture. I just like this kind of stuff. But one thing I find very interesting is the Brooklyn L's right here. So I'm going to start off towards the East End, because as you can see, this is 1908. So you can see a lot of the lines ended near the border of Brooklyn and Queens, since they didn't extend into Queens yet, with the exception of the Myrtle Avenue line, which went to Middle Village in 1906 via a trunk line, because before it ended at the border at Wyckoff Avenue. Another interesting thing I found out was that the L train, well, the present day L line, it wasn't the L back then, ran to Canarsie Pier. And then it shared 2 stops with the Fulton Street Elevated, which I labeled the A for obvious reasons. And instead of going in the tunnel at Atlantic Avenue and Broadway Junction, it went on the present day J line all the way to close to the Williamsburg Bridge. Now, the Williamsburg Bridge opened in the early 1900s, but before it did, trains terminated at Broadway Ferry, right here. Essex Street opened in either 1906 or 1908, so that's when trains started going across the Williamsburg Bridge, so this is when service just started. I allowed the J train to go to Essex while I let the L terminate at Broadway Ferry, because Broadway Ferry didn't close right away. It wasn't until, I believe, the 1920s when Broadway Ferry and Driggs Avenue closed, and it got cut back to Marcy. And in 1908, the connection between the Broadway line and the Myrtle line wasn't created yet. So there were no M trains going on the Broadway line yet, only passing above. And there was also a Lexington Avenue elevated, which I labeled as the G train, which ran with the J for all intents and purposes from Cypress Hills past Broadway Junction, which was then Eastern Parkway, to Gates Avenue. And then after that, it split off, went via Lexington to Green Avenue, and then it took, well, this is actually Grand Avenue, but then it merges with the Myrtle Avenue elevated at Washington Avenue, and then it goes all the way to downtown Brooklyn, crosses the Brooklyn Bridge, and heads to Park Row. And the F right here, the F train is the 5th Avenue elevated. That's what I labeled it as. That also went across the Brooklyn Bridge, connected at Sand Street with the Fulton Street elevated. The Q right here is the Brighton line, the present day Brighton line, and I labeled it Q to make it easy. I'll show that after the F. So all of these trains connected at Sand Street. Sand Street was a huge station back in the day. The 5th Avenue elevated split from the Lexington and Myrtle at J Street and then went down Flatbush Avenue. Had a transfer at Fulton Street with the Fulton elevated and the Brighton line. And then has a stop at Atlantic Avenue and Flatbush Avenue. And by then the IRT was already extended to Atlantic Avenue. So you had trains stopping there, which I labeled as the number 2. But I don't believe a free transfer was available. I could be wrong. Then the 5th Avenue elevated went down on 5th Avenue, making several stops until 36th Street, where it goes to 3rd Avenue until 65th Street, where it ended. And in the future, when the West End Line and Culver Lines were built, they were connected to the 5th Avenue L So you would have direct service from Coney Island to Fulton Ferry or Park Row. Now for the Q train, the Q train here looks very similar to how it does today, although back then it wasn't called the Q train. Some of the station names were different, as I'll show you in a second. So Avenue U was called Gravesend. This was Elm Avenue. Newkirk Avenue was called Parkville Station. And this was Avenue C, Beverly Road. Church Avenue was Church Lane. And also, the Q train, well, the Brighton line didn't go under Flatbush Avenue back then. It wasn't built until about 1920 with the dual contracts. So instead, all Brighton trains went along the current Franklin Avenue shuttle route, making stops at Consumers Park, which turned into Botanic Garden, Park Place, Dean Street, and then Fulton Street, and then it merged with the Fulton Street L, heading west to Fulton Ferry, making stops along Fulton Street, which I find pretty awesome. In all honesty, I would say the Fulton L is my favorite Brooklyn L, so I find that very awesome. And sometimes the Brighton line would even go across the Brooklyn Bridge to Park Row, I read. So yeah, here's the Fulton L, which I labeled as the A, and all its stops. Manhattan Junction, Broadway Junction. It shared tracks with the Canarsie Line for two stops, Atlantic Avenue and Eastern Parkway. And in 1918, I believe, in the 1910s, it was extended because its last stop was Grant Avenue right before the border. But in the 1910s, it was extended over here into Queens, all the way to Lefferts. But in 1908, that wasn't built yet. Oh, let me show you the Third Avenue L. I don't think I showed that yet. So the Third Avenue L is pretty much the same Third Avenue L that got torn down in the 70s, with the exception of the northern tip, because Gun Hill Road wasn't built yet. So pretty much the last stop back then was Bronx Park Terminal around 198th Street, right before Bedford Park Boulevard. Because the Third Avenue L, in its completed form, went all the way up Webster to Gun Hill Road and then turned here for White Plains. But back in 1908, it ended right here, Bronx Park Terminal. So yeah, there was no Jerome line yet. So the Ninth Avenue L didn't get extended into the Bronx as of yet. There was no Pelham line, and the Dyre line was being used by another railroad company at the time. And the Long Island Railroad was using the Sea Beach line, I believe. And there were a lot of streetcars during this time, so, which I didn't include in this map. But yeah, you can use this website to create literally any subway map of your dreams. You have all the icons right here, any train. And if they don't have what you want, you could create a custom one. I even created a map for the outside world using this. My fictional route. So that was exciting. But that's all I have to say. I just wanted to show off this map. I think it's pretty cool. Showing how the subway was in 1908. Thank you all for watching. And have a great day.